Hello, and today I'll be showing you how to set up hammer for Underhell. Now, I may rush through this, so you may want to pause the video and do the action that I do. So you're going to want to have Steam installed, obviously. Open up Steam, and go to Library, Tools, and then you're going to want to usually scroll down and look for Source SDK Base 2013 Multiplayer. You're going to want to right-click on it and click Install. Obviously, I already have it installed. So, once it's fully installed, right-click on it again, then go to Properties, go to Local Files, and then Browse Local Files. Okay, once you've done that, you're in the Source SDK folder. Now you're going to want to go to Source Test, open it up, and open up gameinfo.txt, or gameinfo. It'll open up in a text editor, usually Notepad. You're going to want to scroll down until you see lines that say Half-Life 2 underscore LV. It may be a little different for you because I'm using the single player version of the gameinfo.txt, for example. So you're going to want to delete these two lines. You're going to want to delete these two lines, and you're going to want to delete any lines that are like this, but you're going to want to keep all, you're going to want to keep all six of these lines intact. Delete any other lines that are next to these. That's including these. So delete those. Then you're going to want to enter down. You're going to want to press tab until you get to there. Then put game, tab. Then once you get to there, where my thingy is at, you're going to want to do quotation marks. And I'm not sure what this is called, but I'm just going to call it a line thingy. You're going to want to hold shift. And right above enter, you're going to want to press the key that has the backward slash on it, and it will make that line thingy. Then type in gameinfo underscore path, line thingy again. Now you're going to want to find your Underhell installed, where you installed Underhell at. So minimize that, and you can go to the folder that you already opened. You can go back until you get to Steam Apps. Now you should see the Source Mods folder. Double click on that. Double click on Underhell. Now once you're in here, you're gonna want to go up to here, where this is the URL for where it's at, or whatever it's called. You're gonna want to copy this. Then you want to open up that gameinfo.txt again, and copy and paste it here. Then quotation mark at the end, and you should be set. So click on save and not save as. Close it. Now you want to close this and do browse local files again in the Source SDK 2013 multiplayer properties. Browse it again. Go to bin. Now scroll down until you see hammer with the symbol of the hammer in blue and green. Now you're going to make a shortcut for it so you can easily get to it. Minimize these and drag the shortcut out and put it there. Now obviously you can rename it to like Underhell Hammer for this example. Okay, you can close this folder now. Double click on the icon. Now press on Source Test. That's where the gameinfo.txt comes in. It mounts Underhell, overwriting the Half-Life 2 files. Now you're going to wait for this to load up, which was actually pretty fast. Now as you can see, Underhell was loaded right down below there. Now you're pretty much set, you can start making maps for Underhell. But there's one thing you need to do with your maps. You're gonna want, okay, so if you wanna make a new map, you're gonna wanna do new. Now you're gonna wanna save it in the maps directory of Underhell, so you can update it properly. You're gonna wanna do save as. Now you're gonna wanna find the Underhell directory, so I'm just gonna take a shortcut here. Actually, no, I need to show the example. Go to local disk or your C drive. Go to profile files 86. Scroll down to where it says Steam. Scroll down again and look for Steam apps. Now go into the source mods folder, Underhell folder, and then the maps folder. And just like that, save your map here. Once you've done that, I'll just make a simple test map here. Okay, so now I made a simple test map here, and just do one map. You don't actually have to do the copy file, that just copies it to source test. And don't checkmark this. This will run source test, which source test won't sync up with Underhell. So it may give you some errors. So just make sure this is uncheckmarked, and this is optional if you want to uncheckmark it, but make sure these are checkmarked if you want to run them. Just go. And basically once you see copy the clipboard, that means it's done. So now you can launch up Underhell if you go to the library and look for it. Just play it up here. Hopefully I have this windowed. Yes, I do. Okay, I'm gonna pause it, since I did mount a lot of stuff to Underhill, so it's gonna take a little while. Alright, it's loaded up. Now, you just gotta test your map. So you're gonna wanna enable the console, which is options. Keyboard advanced, and then enable console, then apply. So you're gonna want to type map and then the map name, which in this case the map was named test map, then submit. And bam,
debugging.
And also I have a lot of modified files, so that's why he looks like this, and I should have gave myself weapons. There we go. Okay, so that's how you start. So hopefully this gets people to start mapping for Underhell, and now we don't have to just do this one map, which was on the unofficial co-op thing. So hopefully this will get people to start mapping for it, because I know I am. So hopefully you found this tutorial helpful, and if it was too rushing for you, you can go ahead and look at the CS, the game banana version, which is just a text version that I show through on screenshots. It'll be included in the description and AR useful stuff. So I'll try to make some tutorial videos on how to use Underhell without a FGD file. So I'll see you later. That's what that button does.